Hello guys, this is Raven from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 57.
As far as the cyber threats are concerned, India are the most targeted user groups in the world, and the Norton Cyber Safety Insights report of 2021 has shed come light on exactly what the trouble areas are. As per the report, most Indians are targeted by online identity thefts. While this is not strictly surprising, the numbers put the seriousness in perspective. Norton claims that, as per the survey, over 45% of adult internet users in India faced identity theft in 2020. This number is up by almost 40% since 2019, and 2.7 crores Indians were targeted by online identity thefts in 2020. That's about 2% of India's entire population. Flipkart has announced that its hyperlocal and superfast service, Flipkart Quick, that promises delivery of products in just 90 minutes, is now available in cities like Delhi, Gurugram, Ghaziabad, Noida, Hyderabad and Pune. Customers can order COVID-19 essentials, fresh fruits and vegetables, dairy, meat, groceries, mobile, electronics and baby care products, delivery at their doorstep within hours. The company also aims to expand Flipkart Quick to other metros such as Kolkata and Mumbai in a phased manner. MediaTek launches its first flagship 5G chipset, the Dimensity 1200 processor, in the Indian market at the 8th MediaTek Technology Diaries virtual session. As we know that the company has already announced a Dimensity 1200 earlier this year in China. MediaTek has also confirmed that Realme is the first smartphone brand to feature the MediaTek Dimensity 1200 processor in India. This will be the Realme GT Neo smartphone that was launched last month in China. Realme is working on a new phone, and it may be Realme 8 Pro 5G. Realme 8 Pro 5G may be powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 750G processor. Realme is already launching the Realme 8 5G in India on April 22nd. Realme is gearing up for the Realme 8 series launch, and the company has also teased the Realme Smart TV launch in India. The company's CEO Madhav Seth uploaded an image teasing the launch of the upcoming Smart TV. Seth's post confirmed that the TV will have a 43-inch screen. The CEO did not reveal the exact launch date, however we can expect the Smart TV to launch early next month. Seth has also teased the launch of sub-50-inch Realme TV in India. Seth had also teased the launch of sub-50-inch Realme TV in India as well. OnePlus Q series TVs to receive update with camera app to power the upcoming plug-and-play webcam. OnePlus webcam is expected to launch on next month and will likely to have a physical shutter which provides us privacy. The global smartphone shipments have been significantly rising in the first quarter of this year. Shipments have reached about 350 million units in total, market growth of 24% year-on-year, with Samsung leading the industry in terms of shipment. To know more about this information, check on the image on the display. Redmi has confirmed that it will launch its first gaming smartphone, the Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition, in China on April 27. After the teaser release, the launch invite shows a dedicated gaming button on a side and a circular LED light around the lens module that glows when the buttons slide. The other image confirms a power button with a side-mounted fingerprint sensor. We can also see the text on the both sides of the camera module, freezing and speed test. We can also see the text on both sides of the camera module, freezing and speed test, that may indicate the heat dissipation system can be improved and the performance is better. Xiaomi has recently patented a new smartphone with a unique camera design. The patent showcases a handset with a camera module that has a thunderbolt-like design on the rear of the device. Chinese tech giant ZTE took the industry by storm by releasing the first 100 display camera packing phone last year. Well, the model number known as Axon 20 5G has since been released for the international market, but the UD camera technology is far from being the feature that would interest you the most on the devices. As per the leak, Xiaomi, Samsung, Oppo and others will launch 100 display camera flagships this year. Samsung Galaxy F52 5G has been bagged with Wi-Fi Alliance certifications. The phone comes with a dual-band Wi-Fi and an Android 11 as its OS. Samsung Galaxy F52 5G has already received the Bluetooth, SIG and China's 3C certifications. Honor 50 will arrive before the Huawei P50. Honor 50 series will reportedly arrive in May 2021. The design shows pill-shaped camera layout. Facebook is updating its data probability tool that will now allow users to send or transfer their Facebook posts and notes to third-party applications such as Google Docs, Blogger and WordPress.com. The social media platform already allowed users to transfer photos and videos to other applications such as Backblaze, Dropbox, Google Photos and Koofer. Notably, the tool is now renamed Transfer Your Information, which is redesigned with privacy, security and utility in mind. Facebook notes that users can transfer posts, notes, photos and videos videos with 6 simple steps, and all the data is transferred in an encrypted manner.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow DigiIntegrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.